The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Praise the Lord, everybody! Amen. Hey! Amen. Praise God today! It's a beautiful day outside, isn't it? Yes. Hey, we thank God for waking us up this morning, giving us another beautiful day, another day to praise His name, amen, to thank Him, to worship Him for all that He is doing.
Amen.
And God is an awesome God.
Yes, He is.
All right, I just thank Him for all what He's doing in my life, the way He's leading me, the way He's keeping me and my family safe and leading us and guiding us. I just thank Him for that. He's awesome. Anybody have any praise reports or testimonies?
I just want to thank and praise God for how He has kept me through my lifetime. Sometimes we need to look at where we were and where we are now with the Father. And I thank Him, yes, for His protection, for His mercy, for His love, for His forgiveness. I thank Him for the joy that He's placed inside my soul.
Amen.
I thank Him for the determination to continue to walk and talk and be with Him. I thank Him for being my Father, my,
yes,
Daddy.
Amen.
The one that loves me above regardless of what I do.
Yes.
He loves me. He forgives me. And I give God the glory for all that He does in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for all that He does,
amen,
for us. Anybody else? Wes?
For continued guidance and healing.
All right. Continued guidance and healing.
Amen.
Bill?
I'd also like to give thanks and praise and glory to God. Echo Pastor's sentiments. My entire life I've been blessed.
Amen.
He's guided me. He's guarded me. He's granted wisdom and strength.
Yes.
Along with blessings.
Amen.
And such an indescribable, as the song says, a never-ending reckless love.
Yes. Amen.
Just to continually to love us every day as He does.
Every day.
And it's just such a blessing to know that you are loved.
Amen.
To know that you are guided. To know that you are forgiven.
Yes.
To know that God Almighty does more than just sit on the throne. He's actively, continually,
yes,
watching over each of us.
Yes, He is.
And blessing us. And,
amen,
still loves us.
Amen.
Man, I just want to thank Him and glorify Him in any way that I possibly can.
Amen. Yes. God is awesome.
Yes,
I thank God
is
for His love. Man, He loves us no matter what.
Amen.
No matter what we do, He loves us.
Mm-hmm.
I just thank God for that. Anybody else? Okay, we'll get into today's devotional. And as always, it's coming out of Jesus Calling. It says, stay calmly conscious of me today, no matter what. Remember that I go before you as well as with you into the day. Nothing takes me by surprise. I will not allow circumstances to overwhelm you so long as you look to me. I will help you cope with whatever the moment presents. Collaborating with me brings blessings that far outweigh all your troubles. Awareness of my presence contains joy that can endure all eventualities. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God. God just wants us to, he wants us to think of him all the time.
Amen.
He wants us on our, he wants him on our hearts all the time.
Amen.
No matter what we do.
Amen.
Everything we do, every moment, we should be thinking and thanking God.
Amen.
That's what he made us for.
Amen.
He wanted us to praise him, do his work, spread his word. Amen. Thank God for that. And now we're going to do something else. We're going to sing praises to our King. Amen.
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 All right, Dale, come up.
Thank you.
holy, Lord. Yes, Lord, we thank you. We praise you. We worship you, Lord. Amen. You are holy. Amen. Again, we do not own the rights to this music. This is not our original music. Okay, what?
This is 10,000 reasons.
10,000 reasons.
Oh, my soul.
He is wonderful.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
What a wonderful God you serve. Amen. Hallelujah. At this time, we'll prepare for our offering.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for this offering. Amen. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we come to you right now, Lord. We lift this offering up to you, Father. And we ask that you bless it. We pray that you always bless it, Lord. And we thank you for that, Lord God. And we thank you for all the hearts that are here today, Father. We ask that you bless them and touch them, Lord God. And let someone be out of here different than when they came in, Father. Father, you know all the things that's going on in all our lives, Lord. We ask you to work it out, Lord God. Stay with us, Father. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. This next song is for our everlasting God. I heard this song probably a couple times. I really like it. So share with you. Amen. Okay, Wes.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? Who shall I be afraid?
Who shall we fear?
The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? I will wait on you.
I will trust in you.
You are the everlasting God. Amen. At this time, we'd like to bring up our pastor. Amen. Give her a round of applause as she brings us the word the Lord has given her. Amen.
One more time. Praise, praise, praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The praise and worship, the songs that they selected were right on time. Hallelujah. I will remain confident in this. I will see the salvation of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Father God, hallelujah, I come to you right now. In your precious name, thanking you for today. Thanking you for my life. Thanking you for the lives of all those who are here today. Thanking you for those who are listening in. Father God, we give you the glory. We give you all the honor and all the praise. Lord, as I decrease, you increase within me, Father God. Help me to bring forth the word that you have given me today, God. With power and authority under the anointing of the precious Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, have your way with us today. Lord, you are God. And we thank you for the opportunity to even be in your presence. And we give you the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. For we ask it all in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I thank God for today. I thank God. I was praying and praying. I said, Lord, what is it that you want me to share with your people today? Then I was looking at something as I was scrolling through my phone, and I was listening to this one pastor, and they were talking about the various Psalms in the Bible. And they landed on Psalms 23, and the message was awesome. And I thank God for it, because it was something that I needed right then. And as I was closing my Bible from that, the Lord said, look at Psalms 23 and what it's saying, not only to you, but what will it say to the people, to my people. And even this morning, as the Psalms were going forth, and I was looking over what God gave me as far as his word, and we are going to talk about Psalms 23 today, but as I was going over his word in my mind, I was looking at my notes. The Lord spoke to me and said, the Trinity lies in Psalms 23. And I said, Lord, and I could feel the Holy Spirit as I was reading. There were certain scriptures and certain things that the Lord revealed to me in this psalm. Not just what I had already written down, but other things. He was giving me other scriptures to go along with it. A lot of times we'll read God's word and we see one thing. Then we go back and we read it again, and God gives you even deeper insight into his word. And that's what he did for me today. I want us all to turn to Psalms 23. Most of us might even know this Psalms by heart. Psalms 23. And when you find it, those of you that can, please stand for the reading of God's word. Psalms 23. This is the Psalm of David. And we're going to look at this today, the 23rd Psalm. And it says here, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You may be seated. We're going to go through this psalm, and I want you to really take to heart what God is saying, because the entire Trinity can be found in Psalms 23. It starts off with "the Lord is my shepherd." And that talks about a relationship. If you know anything about a shepherd is one who looks after his sheep, who looks after the flock. He makes sure that all of you, all of his sheep are in good order, in good shape, are well. He even goes out and uses his rod to bring those in that may have strayed off to make sure that they don't be injured in any kind of way. That calls for a relationship. That calls for us to have a relationship with the Father. In "the Lord is my shepherd," God is our shepherd. He sent Jesus to be here with us, to show us the right way to live. It's a relationship. It's a relational situation. It's not one where we can say we're religious. It's a relationship. The Lord is our shepherd. He's going to take care of us because we're his children. We're called by his name. He's going to make sure that everything that we need, everything that we desire, according to his word, will come forth in his word for us. He's our shepherd. And it says, "I shall not want." That means whatever it is you need, the Lord will supply. He will supply. God will supply whatever you need. And how will we receive it? You'll see in John 14:14, it says, "Whatever you ask in my name," that's Jesus Christ, "you will receive." If we ask it in the name of Jesus, you will receive it according to God's word. So that shows you that God the Father and God the Son are working in cooperation with us to show us that whatever it is we desire on earth, you know, there's things that we want. Some things are not according to God's will, but we want them. God is not going to always give you what you according that's out of his will. He's not going to always give you that. And sometimes he will allow those things that's really not in his will to come in our lives, and we'll see it's not for us, and he will help us to get out of those situations. It's not always situations that God wants us to be in, but we put ourselves in because we ask. And we ask God, and we pray over. I know what happened to me in my life. There was times when I asked God, and God had said no. And I still ask him, and he said, "If you do it," he said, "I'm going to open that door. If you do it, you go through that door. If it don't turn out the way that you wanted, I told you no. But you want to go in it anyway, I'm going to let you." And he did it. For 13 years, I was in hell. Because I wanted something so bad. And I had put all my hope and dreams in it. And God could not sway me from wanting this thing. And I asked for it. He gave it to me. And I found out it's not what he wanted me to have. And all that time, I had to ask him, "Lord, forgive me. I asked you for something, and I got something that I really didn't need in my life because it took me away from you." Whenever God shuts a door or tells you no, there's a reason behind it. And that reason is because it's something that he does not want you to have to endure. It's something that he does not want you to have, not because he's being mean. It's because he knows that it would draw us away from him. And he does not want us to be drawn in any way away from him. Satan will put a whole lot of things that look good in front of you. But everything that looks good is not always good for us. So we have to remember to whatever we ask in the name of Jesus, make sure it lines up to the word of God. Make sure it lines up to what God will have for you to have in your life. And if it does, and it's good for you, God will bless you with it. And you will prosper in whatever it is. He will supply that need. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. That's rest. Again, this is Jesus. In Matthew 11:28, it says, come unto me, all those that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus, God the Father, is our shepherd. Jesus is our supply. Jesus will give us rest. We will find rest for our souls if we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We can rest on the fact that the enemy can no longer possess us. He may oppress us and give us hard times, but he can never possess us because Christ has his blood was shed for us. And it covers us. And it protects us and keeps us. So he will give us rest. We can rest on his word. We can rest on every promise that he's given us. Jesus will give us rest. He leads me beside the still waters. The Holy Spirit is our lead. When Jesus went home to glory, he sent us the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is our guide. He is the one that leads us by still waters. That means if you really look at a situation, if you look at a river, on the top is still. But if you get in that water, most times underlying is a rushing wind, a rushing water, and it'll sweep you away if you're not careful. The Holy Spirit protects us by helping us to stay afloat, to stay on top of the still water, to be where the water is still, to walk around with the still water, not to be in the deep end where we might get, where we might drown or get pulled under. If we allow him to lead us, he'll lead us beside the still water. He'll give us a refreshment. He'll give us a peace that passes all understanding because he's the one that's guiding us. And the Holy Spirit in the Word says he doesn't do anything that the Father and that Jesus don't know about. He doesn't do anything that he hasn't heard and that God doesn't want him to do. So God the Father is our shepherd. Jesus will be our supplier as long as we walk with him. And the Holy Spirit is our guide that will lead us by the still waters. He restores my soul. All of us, prior to having a life with Jesus, our souls were in need of restoration. Our souls were so tied up and wrapped up in what the enemy was doing and what the world was doing, and we were not happy even though we thought we were. We were in a superficial happiness. But Jesus, he died on the cross. He shed his blood. And then he sent the Holy Spirit to us for healing. Our hearts needed healing from the pain that we may have endured. Our hearts needed healing. Our soul needed healing. And God said he restored our soul. It's a healing. The blood of Jesus, every stripe, he said, by my stripes, you are healed. He heals us. He restores us back to that place that God will have us to be with him. Restoration, healing, Jesus, they all work hand in hand. Jesus, he leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Hallelujah. We're guided by the Holy Spirit once again, leading us in the path of righteousness. But do we hear? Are we heeding that still small voice that comes to us, that leads us down the right path? There are two lanes. Hallelujah. There's two lanes. We can either go the way God would have us to go, or we can stay going a lane that is away from the Father. And the longer we stay on that road away from the Father, the farther and farther and farther away we will get from the Father. We need to get on the right road. And Jesus, if you look at the Word, if you look at his life, he leads us in the path of righteousness. And he's doing it for the sake of God, for his name's sake, to draw us back to him. Hallelujah. It says he leads us in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. God named us. We have a purpose. God said, let us make man. And he blew his breath into man. From the dust of the earth, he blew his breath, and man was created. Hallelujah. God lives in us. His Holy Spirit lives in us. We were brought back to him for his name's sake, because he created us to be holy. He created us to be his child, not a child of the world, but one that will look at him and will be guided by him, one that will be able to praise him and lift him up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For his name's sake, he's given us a purpose. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, we might be persecuted by the enemy. We might be tested by God. Walking through the valley of the shadow of death, that doesn't mean you're going to die. You might feel sometimes that situations that you're dealing with are like a death. I mean, they're hard. Sometimes we're hard-pressed on every side. But I remember the old saying, no pain, no gain. We might have to go through some pain, but we're going to gain, because if we go through successfully, allowing the Holy Spirit to lead us, even though we're persecuted by the enemy, we don't give in. We're like a Job that don't give in. Then God might test us through that situation. I told you before, a teacher is always silent during a test. You might be being persecuted. You don't hear God's voice. But you know what? If you go through that test successfully, you'll look back and say, I made it. I made it once. I overcame that situation. I'll overcome the next situation that comes my way. If I've done it once and God brought me through, I know I can do it again and he'll bring me through. Because the Bible says that he that overcometh, hallelujah, God wants us to be overcomers. He doesn't want us to be mamby-pamby and woe is me and crying and going through pity parties when we are children of the Most High God, when we have Jesus Christ, when we have the Holy Spirit, when we have all the Trinity for us, and then we're going to cry because of the situation we're going through. We need to rejoice when we're being persecuted. You might say, that is crazy. No, rejoice. That means that there's something God has placed inside of you that the enemy is afraid of. So if he can get you to whine and not have faith in God that he's going to bring you out, then he's keeping you from your purpose. keeping you from what God would have you to be. So if you're being persecuted by the enemy, shout it out. Thank you, Jesus. I praise you, God. I'm going to go through this. I'm going to make it. I'm going to get to the end. And I'll be able to tell the devil, this is one you have not won. Because God brought me out. He brought me through. And we have to look at it that way. Never look at the persecution that the enemy put on you as, oh, God, what am I going to do? No, praise God all the way through. Because he will lead you through that situation. You might be at the shadow of death, but remember, it's just a shadow. It's not real. It's a shadow of death. God will bring you through it if you allow him to. It says, I will fear no evil. The Holy Spirit protects us. A host of angels is all around us, ready to go to war for us. All we got to do is ask. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is right there in the midst. He's our protector, our guide. He will show us. He will show up and show out. Hallelujah. If we give him the opportunity to do so. Hallelujah. Hallelujah says, for you are with me. Faithful. Faithful. God the Father is faithful. His word will not go out and come back void. It accomplished what it's been set out to do. God has spoken over us. We are his children, called by his name. I don't know of any daddy, as powerful as our Father is, that will allow us to be destroyed. He's not going to do it. The enemy may have a little bit of power. He is not all powerful. God is all powerful, and that's our daddy. Jesus gave his life for us. When he died on that cross, he said, it is finished. That means everything has been covered by the blood. There is nothing that we will go through that is not covered by the blood. And he knew there was going to be times when we might feel a little bit weak. So he sent his Holy Spirit to be our guide, to guide us back to the Father through every valley, through every cave, through every situation, through every persecution, through every victory, through every mountaintop experience. The Holy Spirit is right there with us to bring us to victory. Hallelujah. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit reside in Psalms 23. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Hallelujah. Again, discipline. The Holy Spirit disciplines us. He will let us know when we're off track, and he will gently pull us back on track so that we will always go according to what God would have for our lives to be. The Holy Spirit will guide us. We only have to make sure that we hear what the Spirit is saying. Hallelujah. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Again, that's God preparing us, giving us hope and freedom. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. How is that? Think about it. People dogging you out, talking about you and everything else, and God is blessing you on top of it. He blesses you above all blessings. And your friends, the ones that talk about you like a dog, is looking like, how are they doing that? What's going on in their life? And they're talking about you. They're watching you. And they put backstabbing and everything else. But God is still blessing. You still have a smile on your face. You're still walking with your head held high. Even though they dog you out and talk about you, God is still making a way for you. God the Father will always be there for you. You anoint my head with oil. God wants us to be consecrated to him. He anoints us. He appoints us. And he sends his guide to guide us. And all we have to do is be obedient to what the Spirit is saying. My cup runneth over. When you are obedient to the Father, what does he say? Goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Blessings will run you down and overtake you. Everything that you ever thought you might have won in the Father, you will receive. When we obey God, when we're obedient to his word, when we're doing the work of the Father, and that is to show love for our fellow man, to draw others into his kingdom, blessings will run us down and overtake us. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's security and that's eternity. All God wants us to do is to obey his word. Goodness and mercy will definitely follow us all the days of our life, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So when you read Psalm 23, look for the Father, look for the Son, look for the Holy Spirit, because they're in his word. They're together. The Trinity is in God's word. And all he wants us to do is to love him just like he loves us. God loves us. He wants the best for us. He will do whatever he can do for us. He did the ultimate sacrifice when Jesus gave his life. Trust God and know that everything is going to be all right. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Wes, would you mind telling Lane to come down?
Yes.
And while we're waiting, I want to remind you the week of July 18th through the 23rd, we're having a breakthrough revival. If you are dealing with situations, if you want, hallelujah, God to do something in your life, if you're tired of being tired, come to this revival. It's a breakthrough revival. And we got some awesome speakers every night, Monday through Friday. And then Saturday, we're going to culminate with our annual community carnival, bounce houses and food and ice trucks and all kinds of things. We're going to have a wonderful time in the Lord. Clothing giveaway. It's going to be a lot of things that we do, and each and every night, God's word is going to go forth in praise and worship and in his word. And we're looking for people to come and get a breakthrough. We don't want you, when you come in, you might come in one way, but when you go out, you're not going to be the same. God will have touched your heart, and things will see, you will see a change in your life. If you come in earnest, wanting to truly hear from God, you will hear from God. So we're looking forward, July 18th through the 23rd, every night from 7 to 9. God is going to be in the house, and we want you in the house with us as well. God bless you all. In Jesus' name, amen.
If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice, tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life, there's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. Lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, oh, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you feel alone, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. Oh, if you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, oh, he's a chain breaker.
Community Radio 95.7 FM WELT is interrupting our regular programming for this special feature. Today, community and public radio stations across America will come together in a simultaneous broadcast of John Lennon's timeless song of peace, unity, and hope. Give peace a chance. This collective transmission serves to unite radio listeners from coast to coast in a unified demonstration to support those around the world who are affected by war, reminding us all that we can collectively amplify support for peace across the globe. Community and public radio together for peace. This is Community Radio 95.7 FM WELT.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's it.
I'll return you to your regular programming here on Community Radio, 95.7 FM, WELT.
You. staring into your eyes makes my heart come alive. Suddenly brought to life when I met you. Reaching beyond the skies, running deep, stretching wide. Perfect love realized here with you. Now this love is for real, you will never let go, never let go. More than just words, love beyond my control, out of control. This is real love, this is real love. This is real love, this is real love.
We must get beyond our complacency, our contentment, and our satisfaction, and we must cry out to Him, oh God, pour out your Spirit on us.
The church is a body that is concerned about the last and the least and the lost. The body of Christ operates in function of the least of these.
Never take people's hope away from them. Now, we describe hope with words, but 2,000 years ago, those words became flesh.
Amen.
Hope has a name, and it's Jesus.
Amen.
Nobody on the face of this earth is beyond the reach of the love and the grace of God, and that's why we go.
The secular morals of the 21st century will not silence God's prophets and God's message.
And so we appreciate the legacy of John Wesley, but Wesley alone will not do. And we're grateful for the vision of Phineas Brazee, but Brazee alone will not do. We must go back to the first Nazarene. We have to go back to Jesus. Jesus is our calibration point. Let's thank the Lord for these godly leaders.
So I stand before you and say, yes, I accept to serve you. Thank you.
And so I stand before you today willing and committed to humbly serving my church.
Let's give her another round of applause. Amen. God is so good. This closing song. Again, it's not our original music. We do not own the rights to this music. This song says, every praise belongs to God.
Amen.
Amen. He deserves it. Every praise. All our praise. Amen. Okay, Wes?
Every praise,
Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Let every heart say,
Amen.
Amen. God bless you all. Amen.